Welcome back to Streaming Media NYC here at the lovely Intercontinental Barclay. And I'm here today with Lori Greene. Lori, tell us a little bit about your company, and then we'll talk about what you did yesterday for part of NYC.
Yeah, I was very lucky that I worked at Netflix for 4.5 years. I ran global education. I created an education strategy to enable us to scale, and we did training in 20 countries on 6 continents in many different subject areas of entertainment. Because Netflix does local content for local audiences, sure, using local crew, and that crew isn't always as skilled in global best practices, and they all want to be, so we went in and we would train them. So after that, I just started my own education consulting company, doing education strategy, curriculum development, e-learning, and live training. I've taught for 15 years at NYU. I teach a master's class at Fordham. I taught another master's class at Temple. In fact, my dean is here today.
Oh, nice.
My Fordham dean is here today, and so is my mentee. So I love the idea of teaching because it helps really me with my purpose, which is to help people be the best that they can be.
Both my parents were teachers. My dad retired after 47 years of teaching in STEM and like that. So
yeah.
I always thought, boy, you know, I can't stand up in front of a room of people like that. And just last week, the charity that I run, we have an agreement with some middle school, a middle school for STEM. I had to go present for an hour to 4 7th and 8th grade classes. And as I told Eric Schumacher Rasmussen, who used to run the Streaming Media shows, I was more nervous about that than I've been about panels in probably 20 years.
Oh, that's funny.
Because 7th and 8th graders are totally real.
Yes.
And they also gave me some really good feedback about their frustrations in streaming, including things like audio and video sync.
Love it.
And the latency problems. And they rattled off a whole series of things, which I'll use on a panel tomorrow around sustainability.
Oh, fantastic.
So you mentioned the 4.5 years at Netflix. Was part of that pre-COVID and part of that post-COVID?
Yes. I moved to LA for my job, and it was great to be in LA for COVID and not New York, because it was easier to get in the car and go out into the desert and walk around. So it was Tiger King, it was COVID, it was craziness, and I had only been there for a couple of months. I was there for maybe 5 or 6 months before COVID hit.
So did anything change in the pedagogy and the way that you delivered, or were you already using the Zoom equivalent?
I was already teaching online. I've been teaching online for years and years. It's much harder in a lot of ways to teach online. Some people think it's easier. It's just harder to see the engagement and are people paying attention. And I've just learned how to do it. You have to have a lot of energy and make sure, which I do anyway in person, make sure you're constantly changing up your slides, constantly getting them into breakout sessions, constantly getting them to not just look at a sage on the stage, but to really think about what they're learning.
Okay, interesting. So yesterday you helped with a career track. Describe that, because that's something new that Evans brought to the mix for Streaming Media NYC.
I think it was really smart to bring that to the mix, because so many people are out of work, and if they're not out of work, they're worried about being out of work. So we had somebody come in, Jason Patria, and talk about how to brand yourself.
Okay.
And then after that, we talked about how to take your brand and market it with a panel that I put together with someone from LinkedIn, Dio Harewood from Paramount Studios, a recruiter, Karen Morgan, and somebody in marketing. And that was amazing. We couldn't get people to leave the room to go to the cocktail party because it was so engaging. I spoke a little bit myself. I did a presentation on kind of the 5 steps to pivoting and how you pivot. We also had somebody talk about how to find their purpose. I know I just spoke about my purpose, but we had somebody really do a workshop on how to find your purpose. And I think it was very effective, and people seemed to really hunger for it and really want to know more about how they can do better in their careers.
And to a certain extent, you've got the perfect example yourself, having worked in a large corporation.
Yes.
And then pivoting over to LPG edu to be able to do that on their own. Did you find people want to just go from one big company to another big company, or they want to go start their own thing?
So one of the interesting things was that I had a word cloud with all the jobs I've had in my career, and I was telling everyone that when I was creating it, I couldn't fit all the words on. That's how many jobs I've had in my career and how many pivots and changes that I've done successfully. Some of it was, you know, fated. Some of it was by design, but it was amazing. You know, I think it's hard for people to know right now. It's so hard to find a job. I also mentor students. I'm helping a bunch of students get internships right now. I do people's resumes and LinkedIn profiles, and I write bios for people. And really, I think what they want is they just want a job that satisfies them right now. It's so hard to get a job in a big company. They're doing layoff after. I mean, Netflix has done tons of layoffs, layoff after layoff after layoff. Everyone's doing, you know, layoffs. Everyone's really rethinking it. I don't know. Is it that it's just this year and next year and the economy is going to be better in 2025? Nobody knows. I think a lot of people I know that are looking for jobs just want a job.
Interesting. And I think there's this, what I've found intriguing working with a number of startups is people who were comfortable in the work for home model, but then the mandates came down that they had to come back to the office, and they said, no, I've experienced that freedom. I'd rather go off and do my own thing, maybe not make quite as much to begin with, but it keeps that fulfillment of not having to constantly go back to the office where it felt like busy work or having to sit in your seat like you did in elementary school.
Yeah, I do. I mean, it's interesting because Netflix, Reed went from saying, no one should be working from home, we need to work together, to really morphing his thoughts on it for Netflix and where we sat. I think in the end, the engineering team never had to go into the office at one point. I don't know if it's still like that. I haven't worked there in quite a few months. But I think that some people are like that. I think the economy is so difficult right now that people are willing to go into the office. I don't, you know, to find a job. I think going into the office a couple of days a week is smart. I never had to go into the office because my role was global. I was based in New York, but my team was, you know, the group I was in was all over the world.
Sure.
So I never really had to go into the New York office. We have a lovely New York office, but I would go twice a week because for my sanity, you know,
nice.
Like I just wanted to be with people. I'm a people person.
Well, and you're right. That is a valid point as opposed to just doing something on your own,
yes.
Where you're constantly on your own versus
yes.
that balance of
yes.
social interaction.
Yes.
So looking forward, say, to next year's event, what's good career advice somebody should think about, say, 6 months from now and a year from now?
Well, I thought it was really interesting how the whole day was set up, and I think the advice went, first of all, understand what your purpose is. That's one of the points I had before we even started the day.
Sure.
Definitely understand your purpose. Don't just do something for the sake of doing it because there's money there, because you think it's going to be the future. We were talking about prompt engineering, and I was moderating a panel at Temple University, and we were talking about to a CTO of a small agency in Philly, and I said, oh, you know, prompt engineering, is that something people should be looking at? He said, no, there was just an article written about the death of prompt engineers. I was like, wow, that was quick, right? So purpose is one of them, who you are as a brand. Jason Patria spoke about, are you coffee or Starbucks?
Okay.
Are you a commodity or a brand?
Okay.
So I think that's really important. And then in our panel, we talked a lot about LinkedIn. I was joking. This isn't an ad for LinkedIn, believe it or not. But we were talking about really the power of LinkedIn. And I think it has done amazing for me. And I think it's done amazing for Evan. I think that's how a lot of people have discovered Evan and hired him. And for me, LinkedIn helped me get my job at Netflix. Somebody I knew that I had worked with when I was at BBC. I'd been in the cable business for a long time, for a very long time, for many, many years. And he found me on LinkedIn. And I said, why did you think of me for this job? And he said, because I was reading your posts on LinkedIn. And I knew you would fit the culture. Because the culture is very specific at Netflix. So personal branding, being a positive force, don't go into an interview, don't go into a meeting and just diss anyone, just be very, very positive, really think about what networking, see if you can prepare in advance for any career change, even if you have a job, right, financially, volunteer, just say yes, I say to a lot of my students. So there's a lot of things that can happen, and one of the reasons my I started another business, I still do it, LPG Enterprises, which is a marketing and content creation consultancy and personal branding. And so one of the reasons I could do that is because I was on the board of New York Women in Communications, and I had a lot of my client base from there. So volunteer. So there's a lot of things that steps that you can do in the process. In the end, you have to really work at it, especially in this economy.
Very, very true. All right, Lori, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Fascinating conversation.
Thank you.
And we'll be right back with our next interview.